My house has two entrance doors, one on the second floor and one on the first floor. My Wi-Fi access point is located on the second floor, just above the staircase. So I thought, when I'm away for holiday, a thief could enter the house through the basement door, and hence it would be great if I could have a camera linked to the router on top of the staircase, taking pictures and capturing motion so that it can sound an alarm or maybe send me a message on my mobile if need would be. I checked on eBay and found some really cheap USB cameras. So let's see if we can hook them up to my router. My router has a couple of attributes that make it ideal for such an application. It has a 3G dongle and could hence send me a text message. It is battery buffered, so it will still run even if the main power line has been sabotaged. It has OpenWrt on it and also has a 16GB memory extension, so I could run virtually any Linux software on it. OpenWrt is a very well documented project, so all I had to do was check the openwrt.org website and search for webcam, and I found a complete description of the necessary steps. Okay, let me quickly log into Luci, which is the web interface of OpenWrt. I am opening a command line interface at the bottom at the same time so that I can show you log messages as we do things. You can also access the log from the Luci web interface, but it will not refresh automatically. First, let me plug in the USB camera and see if the kernel recognizes it. Yes, perfect. Unplugging it and plugging it in again. Next step is to go into the software section of Luci by clicking on System and then Software. First thing should always be to update the software list. While the list updates, this might be a great moment to quickly subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. The first software we need are the drivers for the camera. Searching for UVC gives me the Kmod Video UVC package, which I can now install using the GUI. Watch the messages in the log as the modules load automatically. Next, I need the video streamer software. I will use MJPG-Streamer. Same procedure. There is also an interface to Luci available called Luci App MJPG Streamer. Quickly refreshing the menu by selecting any other menu item, and then I can go to the newly created menu item Services MJPG Streamer. This is where I can put in all the parameters for the video camera streamer. So in fact, I do not have to fiddle around with config files or anything of that kind. That's good. The plugin has three sections: HTTP output, file output, and UVC input. Before we customize these, let's quickly check the box to enable MJPG Streamer. I want to use UVC as an input, that is my USB camera, and HTTP as an output. That means I do not want to write the videos to a file, but rather be able to stream using a web interface. By default, MJPG Streamer listens on port 8080. I leave that default as is. If you want it, you could add authentication to it. I'm fine without authentication as there are no secrets in my staircase. On the input side, that is under the UVC input section, you may specify additional camera parameters such as the device name, if you have more than one, or the resolution or the frames per second. As I have made strange experiences with MJPG Streamer on the Raspberry Pi, when specifying the frame rate, I will just remove that parameter. I will leave the other ones as default. Once I click on Save and Apply, the streamer service is started and I can check the results in the log reader window below. On version 18 of OpenWrt, there was a preview window, but this seems to be gone with version 19. Now let me just browse to port 8080 of the router and see if the camera stream appears. Yep, here it is. Yoo-hoo, mom, I'm on telly. cool, now let's see what this looks like if I install it on my staircase router. And here comes the thief. I apologize for the cheap actors I had to take for this video. The budget was pretty much exactly zero, so we had to deal with what we get. The lighting and the video resolution might need some improvement, but I will check this later. It's good enough for motion detection. Next thing I want to do is add the camera to my video surveillance system, which is Shinobi. Check the related video section in order to watch how to run Shinobi in a Docker container. What I like with Shinobi is the ease of use and the large number of cameras and video formats that it supports. I just need to select monitors and click on Add New, and I'm all set for adding new cameras into the surveillance system. I'll just give it a speaking name such as Staircase, specify the input stream format, which is MJPEG in our case, and give it the URL of the camera. I want to stream to my console using WebSocket, which just works fine for me. All set, here we go. The new camera is available for watching, recording, and motion detection. Guys, that concludes today's episode. Thank you very much for watching. Bye for now.